Okay, so in this video, I'll show you how to use this Tomcat 7 Redis installation from my Git repository. This is a public repository, so you are free to fork it or just download the contents and try it on your own system. In order to try this Tomcat 7 Redis installation, you need few things. Like for example, you need to have Kubernetes setup, Kubernetes cluster. I will show you this demo using Docker desktop and Kubernetes on Docker desktop. Second thing that you need is you need an existing Redis instance. Okay, so for Redis cache, what I'm going to use now is I'm going to deploy Redis cache on my Kubernetes cluster directly. But instead of this, you can use any of the PaaS service available on cloud. Like you can use, for example, Azure Cache for Redis, or you can use any other cloud platform for that matter. You just need to have a replicated instance or single instance of Redis running anywhere on your system, and it should be accessible to your Kubernetes cluster. Just to show you a demo, I'll just make sure that my Docker desktop is up and running. I guess it is running already. Yeah, it's running. So from my terminal, I'll show you what I'll do now. Kubectl get all, just to check if it is anything running here. Okay, these are some previous jobs that I created some time back, but otherwise there is no pod or there is no deployment, as you can see here, for any application. I already have Helm installed in my system right now. I'm running Helm 3.4. okay, so let's do one thing. Let's search for Redis. I'm just doing a Helm search repo for Redis. I found one, Bitnami Redis. Bitnami, by the way, is already added. I have already added the repository. What I will do next is I'll do Helm install my, and this Redis instance I want to include in here. So, okay, so my Redis instance is now up. You can see this is my Redis instance. I can easily find out the password also for this Redis instance. So Redis password is equal to, this will get me the password. Wait a second, looks like something is still missing in here. Redis password is equal to kubectl get secret. There's no need of specifying namespace here. Okay, name is my Redis, and I want to extract the value data Redis password from this secret. Okay, so this should get me the Redis password. Password values here in secret are encoded using base64 encoding, so let me use my Ubuntu bash to decode it back. Echo Redis password, this is the encoded Redis password. I will decode it back using base64 encoding, base64-d, and this is the decoded value. So this is the actual password that I need to configure. Fine, I have the password with me. So my Redis password is this. I'll just write it down, and then because Redis is already running inside my cluster, so Redis cluster service name, I'll just show you where is the service name. Service name is my Redis master. Okay, fine. It is my Redis master, and it's currently running on port 6379. Fine. So Redis host in my case is redis:\6379. That's my Redis credentials, by the way. Fine, so I have the required information with me now. So let's do one thing. Let's just download the content of this entire repository and try it out. You don't actually need all the contents, because this repository, if you look here, contains the required configuration files, what configuration you will have to do for your Tomcat. Then it also contains the sample web app, which I have included here, and the libraries or jar files which are required for configuring Redis with Tomcat 7. Along with that, there is a Docker file which will help you build your own image in case if you do not wish to use this image which I have built. What I recommend you guys to do is not to modify the initial few lines till line number 8. Only line number 10, instead of copying my sample web app, you should instead place your application here in this copy statement. Rest everything will remain same, and you will have your own application container bundled with Tomcat 7 and Redison with Redis cache for HTTP session handling already pre-configured. Your application will remain as it is. No additional changes required in app. Fine. So I have the KHS deployment files here. Instead of downloading entire repository, I'll do one thing. I will instead just access these files directly. As you know, kubectl allows you to deploy artifacts directly from given public URLs. So let me first download the config.yaml file. So let's open it in raw mode, control S. And what I'll do is I will create a folder here. I have created a folder in my desktop and I'm going to save this file here. That's my config.yaml file I have saved. After that, I need the other two files. Either I download them into my machine or I can just give the full URL like this. Both the way it will work fine. Let me just download this. This is my deploy.yaml file. Okay, in the same folder, I'm downloading all the files. And then I have got service.yaml file. This is where I have defined the load balancer type service. Load balancer type service will make this sample application, Tomcat based sample application, accessible from outside my Kubernetes cluster. So I'm deploying this all things now on Kubernetes, but as you might have guessed, I need to pass this information in my config file first. So let's open the config file. Here it is. I'll open this in VS Code. You can use any text editor of your choice. Here we are. So just two things I need to update in here. Wait a second. Here it is. So my Redis, here is my Redis host. I need to update it here. And this is my Redis password. Okay. If you don't get password or if you don't provide correct password, you will get no auth exception while connecting to Redis. So configuration file is updated. No changes required in deploy actually. But anyway, I'll explain you what I'm doing in deployment file. I have got two replicas and this is the image which I have built. This image is already available on Docker Hub. Image pool policy, if not present, image is already there locally available in my system and I don't want to spend any more time in downloading it. This is the config map reference, this config map we are referring to. And these are the resource limit which I have placed for this application. In addition to all this thing, you can also provide some kind of what we call it, readiness probe and liveness probe to this application. So to give you an example, I will just apply readiness probe. And readiness probe in Kubernetes actually have certain properties like get HTTP, sorry, wait a second, readiness probe, I have written this wrongly, readiness probe, P should be capital. Okay, then HTTP get, I'll say path is health. My application already has one additional endpoint called slash health, which will simply return HTTP status 200 with the status message okay. This is just to ensure that application is actually responding to all the requests that you make to it. Then application is currently running on port 8080, as you might have guessed, Tomcat by default listen on port 8080, so that port we need to use. Along with that, I will provide some properties like number of failures, should wait for 3 consecutive failures, should try every 20 seconds, and the initial delay second, I want it to be delayed initially by 20 seconds because Tomcat will take that much time approximately to get started. And I can also provide timeout seconds. I don't want this particular request to take more than 3 seconds. So this is now ready. Readiness probe is ready now. You can provide similar values for liveness probe as well. There is a difference basically. Liveness probe will, you know, kind of restart your container if it is not responding. Liveness probe with the same settings as readiness probe. So I have everything now ready. I'm planning to introduce this into my GitHub repository so that by the time you download this YAML file, you will have all these things already in my deployment.yaml file. I will move to the service YAML file. I don't need any changes right now. Selector is matching with my deployment. Ports are matching with my container and service type is load balancer. Fine, let's try now. You can easily deploy all this thing together by just writing kubectl apply hyphen f and then dot. So all the three YAML files will be deployed together and you can check their status. Like for example, if I say get pod, you will see there are 3 instances of Redis running and 2 instances of my app running. But you will see my application is not yet ready. You can see number of containers inside my pod ready are 0. There are 0 pods ready because of that readiness probe. Fine, there is a way you can just filter everything, get pod, label app is equal to my app. That's the pod label. This will show you only the application pod. Looks like one of the pod. Okay, now both of the pods are ready. Let me show you some description about these pods. Before that, let's just create a PowerShell variable to hold all these pod information. $pods equal to, and then let's add it like this. Now, if you want names of the pods, wait a second, there is one small change required. I want output only name of the pod. Now, if you write $pods, you will see there are 2 pods it's listing. This makes it a lot more easier for me in my next kubectl command. Let's try to describe our first pod, and this is what I'm going to do. Pod square bracket 0, because there are 2 of them. You will see this is the pod. Everything is fine. Pod has already started, container started, and you will see it's already responding to the liveness and readiness probe. There were 3 failures, but there was 1 success in both these probes, liveness and readiness probes. So everything is working fine as of now. In case if you want to see the logs of these pod, you can do that as well. Kubernetes or kubectl has the logs command. So let's see kubectl logs, pods 0. And looks like my Tomcat has not reported any exception or any error to me. Any error or any exception, there is nothing like that. Okay. So let's try this application now in the portal. In the web browser, I'll write localhost 9000. This is my sample application here. You will notice this is the session ID 09019AA4F. This is session ID for me. And currently running on this particular pod. And this is my pod IP address. You can, you know, kind of get more information about it if I just run this command. Hyphen O wide. And you will see 179.178. There are 2 pod IP addresses. And right now my service is, my request is processed by this particular pod. Let's try to add some values in here. Like for example, let me add a name value pair. So I have created a new value in my session called name Dakshata Shinde. And this is my session ID, by the way. And this is currently served by this pod. Let's try to kill this pod and see if the session value is still preserved. Kubectl delete pod, and let me write down the pod name. Now, because of the built-in feature, self-healing feature of Kubernetes, the pod will be resurrected, or there would be another pod, a new pod will be created to replace this one. Let's see what happens to my session then when this pod is deleted. I can quickly check if the pod is actually getting deleted here. Kubectl. kubectl get pods. Yeah, pod is getting terminated. That's fine. So let's do one thing. Let's just go back to the browser window here and reload the browser window. You will notice one thing, the IP address has changed. So this request is served by the other pod because first pod is going down. So request has to be handled by the other one. But you will see it's still showing me the same value from my session. Even if I remove these attributes from here, yeah, the value is still there. And you will see the session has also remained same. There's only one single session there. In case if you are wondering, is it possible to, you know, get inside the Redis cluster and to get know whether it's actually having that session, you can do that. Kubectl exec hyphen it. Oh, wait a second. I need to know the pod name, right? It. Okay, let's try to connect to the master instance here. This is the master instance. And bash. This way, I will directly get inside the Redis master. Let's use Redis CLI with the password. Wait a second, what is my password? This is my password, okay? Okay, so I'm now inside my Redis instance on the primary node or master node. Let's try this get star. Sorry, not get star, I want keys star. I want to see all the keys. And you will see this is my Redis session key. You can cross verify this with my browser page here. You will notice the session ID here, 019AA, 019AA is exactly matching in here. Okay, this is the prefix which Redisson added automatically to our every key. Hget all, and let me write the key. I just want to see what data Redis has stored inside this. You will see this is the data Redis has stored, and this is the access time, this is all the detail, and this is the, you can say, one of the attribute which is stored inside it. Okay, all the values are there. So let's do one thing. Let's see what happens if I just open another browser. Let's use Chrome, another browser. Let's make another request from another browser. What will happen is this will actually in turn create a new session. Okay, and this session ID is this. Okay, let's do one thing. Let's copy the session ID and try this directly in here. So prefix will remain same. Just add the session ID next to it. And you will see this is the other session. So I've got two session right now. In one session, there is a value called name with this value. So you will see both the sessions are currently served by the same IP. Oh no, this has now changed. Looks like the other pod has started now. Let's use a different name here. And submit. So there is a new value in here. If you now repeat the same command, you will see showing the same name. But whereas here, you will continue to see this old name. So there are two sessions right now. Let me just repeat the old value. You can see the attribute that I have entered over here. Okay, so that's all. So this particular instance is pre-configured to connect with Redis. Redis cache, you just need to provide your Redis host and your Redis password. Okay, optionally you can provide value called mode is equal to single or mode is equal to replicated, depending upon whether you are using single Redis or you are using replicated Redis instance. I will show you where the value is stored. Just go to the config.yaml. Here it is. Right now I'm using replicated. I hope this would be very helpful for you. If you are trying to containerize a Java application, not as a stateful, but as a stateless, using deployment object and replica set, and keeping all your session data into a cache like Redis. Okay, I hope this works. Thank you.